And the funny thing is that the moment I lost the money, right, it was actually during a shoot. During a TDK show, I was sitting right here and I was watching my money bleed out in the morning. But
then after that, John asked you, hey, why are you on your phone? What was your biggest mistake in 2021? This is your daily catch up. Boom.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
We are so disconnected. If you've enjoyed Daily Catch Up content last year and you would like to enjoy more this year, subscribe, like, and ring the notification bell. And this episode is sponsored by Syfe, who's here to help you achieve your financial goals in 2022. Guys, are you ready? Buckle up, buckle up. Okay. So since 2021 is over.
No.
No.
2022. Oh, yay.
Yes.
Depends how your year has been, lah.
And we know that people like to set resolutions at the start of the year, right? So I'm someone that relates strongly to that, setting goals that I will never hit, right? So then, but I chanced upon this article which really, is the word vindicated? Oh, I chanced upon this article which really assured me. Right. So it talked about, the title is, it doesn't matter if you keep New Year resolutions, it's more important to make them.
Oh.
And then I was like, okay, I got the mindset right.
That seems like a very strawberry mentality thing. To say.
Okay, let's see.
Is this
let's
the first thing you're gonna say to me this year?
Oh my god. Happy
New
Year.
Some of Christmas y'all were like
what? They were like what?
I tell you, dude, the Christmas party was f***ing
wild. That's why we're still in the same clothes.
Wait, what Christmas party?
I forget to invite you. So then I'm wondering, how would y'all rate your past year, your 2021?
Rate, like out of 10.
Yeah, before we go into the new year. Yeah. So out of 10, how would you rate your last year?
I'll give it 8.
Wow.
Hmm.
Why you say first? Yeah? We have given it an 8 or so, but now
give it 8,
no,
8.5.
7.5 or
just competitive.
Make it worse a bit.
Since the trend is there, it is 7.
I feel like a 6.
Oh, why?
6.5.
Why?
Why? Why? Why?
So, right. Okay, let me tell you about this article first.
Wait, you asked us to read it.
No, so I'm going to go into it later. Yeah, to right, talk about right. Like, do y'all feel like y'all kept last year's resolutions?
So we'll come back to
But I'm going to comfort y'all first about why it's okay if you didn't keep them.
Please.
So basically, you talk about how setting resolutions, right, is basically about changing outcomes, right, needs to stem from changing your self-perception. Because that then it changes your process.
Right.
So therefore, therefore setting New Year resolutions like frames your mind for the rest of the year. It helps you articulate like what you value more than other things. So for example, right, if you come up with a resolution to leave work by 5 PM so that I can spend time with my family, then that tells you that family is important to you and in fact, perhaps a little more than work.
Okay.
And so therefore, in all your decision making throughout the year, right, you will then end up making decisions that will favor your family and help you achieve that goal.
Yeah.
Mm. I can see that. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why it's good to make resolutions. So, did y'all make resolutions last year?
Wait, sorry, on that note, right? Mm. Also quite interesting, I mean, I was just thinking about it. That because we are always like very busy on our day-to-day grind, right? Like trying to accomplish the 100 things we set out to do each day. But New Year resolution is one of those things, right? You take a step back, you look at the whole year in a macro view, right? And you try and just accomplish one thing.
How one? Mm.
You only set one resolution.
I didn't set resolutions. But if I would, I think I would make one goal. Like I would like to spend more time with family or like be a better boss accounting, you know? Like it's just one thing.
Mm.
Whereas every day you go into the grind, right? It's like so many things that you're trying to do, right? But you just set out to do one thing or the whole year to accomplish it.
Actually, that's quite a good idea. But then I'll feel like I leave many things out.
I feel like, you know, it's like one of those like hatchlings kind of thing. Like you lay a lot of eggs so that cause some might die and then some might survive.
So you just hit 1 out of 10.
Yeah, correct. But I also believe, right, so this is something that I've learned about resolutions over time. Like you learn in school about how to set goals, right? I think it's the same thing as resolutions. It's got to be specific, measurable. Smart. Yeah, exactly. Smart goals. SMART, which is specific, measurable. What was AR?
Attainable.
Yeah, attainable, achievable.
Reasonable. Which also means achievable.
What is R?
Realistic. No,
but
saying,
that's attainable though.
It's attainable though.
Okay, so we have a smart goal.
Maybe A is Atam.
Yeah. So R&T lah.
Technology.
Oh my god, it reminds me of the
aspiration.
Wow, I really need to look this up lah.
Why did you bring this up? You don't know anything.
No, I remember it just being like measurable. Yeah, so it's specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and
technology.
Time bound lah, which means that you set yourself until the end of the year to do it. No, but it's quite important because sometimes people will say something that is so flighty, right? Then you obviously won't hit it because it's not even achievable.
Like try to lose weight. Okay, cannot be that.
Like how much weight?
The gym sign ups at the start of the year.
Yeah.
That cancel.
That's what really happens. Like January, February, March is when they make the majority of their money. Apparently.
No wonder April the gym so empty.
Also cause I think people eat a lot during the New Year's and Christmas holidays.
Yeah, it's the holiday season, right? Mm-hmm. For like a good 2 months.
Mm-hmm. So last year did y'all set any resolutions? You said you didn't, right?
I don't. But we need to set business goals. So I guess to me it's the same thing really, these days.
But your business goals, is it set because you need to tell the company or is it you actually have goals?
Have fun.
Just because you need to tell the company.
Everyone's very lost.
Just make up some shit, right?
Yeah. Let's just go with it. No. Part of it is that, to be honest, the fact that I'm accountable, right, to explain the future of the business makes me need to think about certain shit. But then you say it, really, then you do.
But I feel the difference about setting goals and not setting goals is honestly, right, it sounds damn stupid, but it's really just having the time to just sit down and think about it. Because a lot of people don't really spend that time to think about it.
Exactly.
I set two resolutions. One of them I set every year for the last 5 years and I haven't hit them yet. And the second one was quite specific to last year and I did it, thankfully. So the first one, again, it didn't even follow the smart goals. I don't know why I brought it up. The first one was to learn Chinese. You can't even measure it. I should have done graduate from primary one Chinese.
Okay.
No, because I really can't speak Chinese, right?
So you set yourself up to fail.
Exactly. Maybe I like that.
And you were conscious of it.
Just to keep you grounded.
Exactly. Wow. Sometimes not too, up there, right? The second thing was to say yes more often. Because I feel like there was a point in my life where I just kept saying no lah. I don't want to do that.
Then take off your shirt.
Well, good thing you're wearing two shirts.
This is the hack when you play street poker. Always wear two layers.
No, they always take out your socks.
You have never played street poker, son.
Not true.
You and your bros are
Chinese New Year coming. Wait, is that not the time for poker?
But not street poker.
Street poker anytime.
Okay.
Unless you're hot relatives.
Siala.
Okay, keep going.
Yeah, so
every episode is actually about incest.
Actually.
So what's the resolution you actually hit?
Oh, I said yes more often. I took up more opportunities because like
you say too much yeses though. Just humble feedback.
Maybe perhaps. No lah, but like
cheating on people's resolutions.
Yeah. Just cause you also have no goals.
2022, you're Mr. Downer, No, but yeah. So like, for example, I hate bringing it up all the time, but like the whole clumsy like business was me saying yes to the original founders to like join it, right?
Mm.
And like me being part of like a lot of different things at the moment was just me saying yes and I feel happy about it.
How about you?
I cannot really remember my personal
relatives.
No, I remember one start of the year. So start of the year, I remember the work goals and I think we managed to achieve them.
Which is what?
I think one was to create something new, which is this, kind of. So I think that was quite cool. Then
good job, man.
The other one was a small one. It's just to get the IG to 10K, which we did. Other competitions. But then I celebrate the wins first.
Go follow our Instagram.
Then the other one was that because right at the start of last year was I was really just learning about all this financial stuff. So the goal of this year was kind of to learn more and to actually start actively investing and whatnot.
Which you did. What were some takeaways that you all had from this year then? Like from whether or not you hit your resolutions, right? Because personally, right, I only set resolutions, very fixed one that I put online for everyone to see, that kind, which I don't know whether people care about.
Nobody asked.
Nobody
asked. Then Denise.
Wait, sorry, before we move on, what were your...
Yeah.
So I'm going to tell you.
Skip the question.
So then, one of the resolutions that I had was do more of the things I love. So
Like carpentry?
So I wanted to pick that up, but then end up I didn't because sawing is too tiring, I need the miter. I need the...
Wow.
Y'all don't know, right?
It's the spinning saw.
Yeah. Correct. Yeah, that was one of them. Another one which I completely didn't hit is don't be late. So then I realized that that's a completely unrealistic goal. So
right.
What were the strategies?
No, at that point I don't know, got all these steps. So I thought it's just I make a goal that I wanna kind of achieve.
Then just
Then the third one that I had was religious, walk closer with God. Which I think I did.
Right.
But nice. That was inevitable as the years passed.
Wait, so you spend a whole year not doing anything that made you happy? Do more?
No,
not
do more
doing
of
anymore.
The things I love.
Did you? Besides carpentry?
Which I barely did.
But you did it anyway.
Which is more than the year before, you see.
So technically, if you measure that, is it up 100%?
I think last year I did more personal things last year.
Right.
Like I play around with GarageBand, that kind of thing. Like explore random interests.
Same.
Yeah. So 2020, because we were stuck at home for that long time, man. But yeah. Then last year felt like a weird in between. So I feel like I was finding my footing in a sense.
Mm. Right.
Yeah.
No. I now that I think about it, I think I made a fleeting resolution.
Hey, look at you.
I told Pat was to be more present with her. Because I realized in 2021, right, even though we were trapped, in 2020, even though we were trapped at home, right, because of, like, very scared the business die, right, to be very honest. Yeah, so even though I was with my parents and with Pat and we are stuck in the same place, right, I was not present with them because I was, like, very worried about the business.
Mm.
Yeah. So
but
in 2021,
you discovered TikTok, so that's out the window.
No lah, TikTok.
After you take one to show me.
Yeah, so that was my personal resolution to be more present with my parents. And then with the business one, honestly, right, Denise was asking me to think about it, right? And the answer was to survive the year. Because in 2021, I think a lot of the business owners I spoke to, right, we all agreed that 2021 was harder than 2020. Maybe not the F&B people. F&B, I think, got it the worst throughout, to be very honest, yeah. But for like service-based businesses like us, right, 2021 was much harder in a sense whereby there were new industries being created. So like cost of manpower became very expensive. Hiring became much more expensive and a lot harder. Yeah, at the same time, a lot of government grants were withdrawn. I mean, rightly so, like taxpayers' money, right? But they were all withdrawn. And so it's really, we've supported you these few months. If 2021, you die, you don't deserve to live kind of vibe.
Right.
Yeah, and at 2021, because the companies with money and war chest, right, they come out all the stun, right? So if you don't have the war chest to compete, right, then you just look like you have a very, very bad workplace. Yeah, so my 2021 resolution for the business was to break even, but we were profitable, so that's nice.
You exceeded.
Yeah, but so what do y'all think were like your takeaways from like the highlights and the worst part of your year? If y'all are okay sharing the worst part of your year.
Mine's a
very considerate host.
Yeah. Okay, self-praise is no praise.
Hey, maybe my resolution this year is words of affirmation for myself.
Okay, my resolution is to shit on people.
It's your problem. She got some power thing going on. Yeah.
Okay, then you
give her an iPad.
I have an iPad.
No, so basically, like my highlight for 2021, right, was a moment in the year where I suddenly just sat back and realized this is it. And what I mean by that requires me to go back almost like what, 12-13 years ago.
Ha!
Well, it's a really long story.
What is this?
Buckle
so that's
up,
why,
guys.
That's why I regret it. I'm going to try to summarize it.
Now it's going to blur out.
Yeah.
Go to like 12 years ago. Standing at a bus stop. Like.
The vintage, the sepia.
Then the year appear at the bottom.
Okay. No, so anyway, okay. For the purpose of this story, right, it's gonna sound like bragging, but it's really not, because it's actually quite sad in like my point of view.
Okay.
So I honestly am someone who feels like I peaked at high school, because I feel like I had everything back then when I was in secondary school, right? Like I was doing so many different things and I was known for being able to juggle everything and be like good at it, decently good at it. So I was like, okay, it's gonna sound like bragging, but whatever, I don't give a I'm owning it.
Because there's a resolution this year.
Yeah. So I was like the president of the student council. I was like captain football team. I was a competitive debater. I was like writing music. I was in a rock band. I was in the choir. I was like, you know, giving, I was doing public speaking. I was like, so like I could speak and form a sentence that I can't do now. For some reason, I lost that ability.
Yeah, I really cannot tell. Sir.
Yeah. And it's genuinely like crazy how I deteriorated from there. Yeah. Because I was really such an extrovert.
Well, I don't know how to feel about it.
And so I saw for the longest time, right, like I think I've also gotten to a very depressive state because I keep thinking about that time.
Okay.
That time when like teachers will always tell me, hey, wow, this guy is going to be successful. This guy has potential and everything. And I think that also contributed to me feeling lazy about where I could end up.
Mm.
And so the following years, I ended up just floating. I felt like I didn't need to make an effort to do anything. My uni years, I never joined a single like club, I was just all by myself. I just barely did well in school, whatever. And like, I just didn't care. Yeah. Okay. And so that kind of paved the entire direction of my adult life, right? I felt like I kind of didn't achieve everything that I ended up wanting to achieve. And so this year was the first time where I felt like I suddenly was saying yes to a lot of things back to the resolution, right? And I was taking on multiple interests again. And even though I may not have been excelling all of them, I felt like, okay, I was finally being useful again. I was being productive with both my work time and my lifetime. That I was being, it was productive, not in the sense that I was creating value of it, but I knew that every hour had a certain purpose. So if I was working on, like, say, my side business, if I was working on a hobby, if I, you know, I started writing music again, I was like picking up a camera again. If I was playing games, it was very much about like spending time with my friends online. You know, like all of this was so like
purposeful
and intentional, right? That I suddenly just took a step back and went, I like where I am right now. Mm. And I haven't said that in a very, very long time.
Damn.
Yeah. Damn.
This is it.
So yeah. So it's that was like the highlight
living
of my year. Yeah.
Like a living.
Exactly,
man.
Exactly. So the main takeaway, I guess, for me was the main takeaway for me was
he's his own client. But you don't kidding about very long answer.
Yeah, I guess the main takeaway for me was like being able to really take that step back and like assess like how am I spending my time, lo, and like whether like I remember I used to hate myself a lot for always procrastinating. I always had like ideas of things that I wanted to do, right? Mm. And I always say, I'll find time like to do it later. And this time, like almost all the time this year, I went, okay, come, let's go and do it, you know. Let's go and pick up something and let's just do it. Like, I feel that whatever, like, let's just do it. So I thought that was something that I was quite proud of myself for doing. So yeah, that was highlight. My year. Hey, no need lah. Okay lah.
Very highlight.
Thank you.
On the note of procrastination, right? This is a conversation I had with John Paul like some time back. That so in 2020, because we were stuck at home, right? So I was doing a bunch of random challenges. Like I wanted to wake up at 4 a.m. for a week, that kind of thing. But then like, so I was thinking, right, would it be possible to not procrastinate at all? Like anything that I think of doing, right, I just get up and go and do it now. Like, would it be possible to do that for maybe say like a week?
Yeah. Then you put it off for a year.
Yeah. Then I procrastinate and never did it. But so I'm just wondering, because that feels like what happened to him, right? He just felt like, okay, this year I'm gonna stop procrastinating, right? I'm gonna start saying yes to things. And then he's happy now.
Mm. Happier lah.
It's the whole like, there was a movie about this, right? You just, are you a doer?
Isn't that Shia?
Just do it! Mark Wahlberg or something, right?
Shia LaBeouf.
Yeah, something like that. Are you a doer or a don'ter or something? Like, you're a doer!
Do it!
Spartan.
But yeah, just do lor. Then that's life in you, right?
You got do anything this year? What's the best thing you do?
Okay, so for last me, year, right? I feel like my, the lowest point in my year.
I asked about best, but you go to the worst.
No, let's do it.
It was a highlight. So like the lowest point in my year was actually like, it turned out to be very, there was a very nice silver lining to it.
Very nice. Oh shit, this is that one. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Sorry. Give this story the due respect, guys.
So basically, we're talking about like investing, this kind of shit, right? So there was a particular investment that I made, okay? And then I already told myself like, I have all these rules that I set up for myself, right? So that even if say I lose money, because I'm quite a high risk person lah. Mm. So even if I lose the money or whatever, I'm totally fine with it, right? No, so I'm going to say the amount to them, but I'm going to bleep it out because I'm just not comfortable sharing the exact amount with everybody else. Okay?
It's fair. It's his life, right?
Yeah. Okay. So
when you scold them,
yeah, I don't know, sir. They're like,
they actually all say okay, but then.
So basically, I invested a decent amount of money in this, and then I was making like quite a decent amount of money, lah, right? What happened was like a couple of months back, right? The markets went crazy lah, and I basically had to protect the amount of money that I had in there. So I pulled together more money, I pumped it in, and then everything tore.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
So margins were involved.
I lost like that. Like in a span of like 3-4 days. Like just like that. And this is like one of like my bigger-ish investments at the moment lah. Yeah. So I like, wow, then I fucking stressed because it didn't happen like very quickly, like just like that happened. You know? It was like I have to watch the market and then just see my money slowly bleeding and bleeding and bleeding and bleeding until everything gone. Then wow, fucking stress.
Wait, there was no way to take that money out already.
No. So at that point, I didn't know Ken. At that point, there was a point where I could have broke even or maybe make a little bit of profit and took out everything, but I didn't understand it well enough. So that was one of the biggest lessons. Like, okay, so one of the first lessons I learned is that, right, really understand what the fuck you're doing before you go and do something. If not, Rabux, yeah. Like, there were so many things I could have done, but I didn't know it only at that point of time. Mm. And by the time I finally realized, it was a bit too late. Okay, no, actually, I'll be honest. There was a point where I could have saved like K and just lose, but I took a gamble. Yeah. So taking a gamble that I lost lah. Yeah. But I think the great part about it was that like once I decided that I was going to write off the right. I was talking to my brother like at night, because we share a room and whatever. So I was talking to him, I told him about it. They just told me like, just like, what is their value to you, right? And how long do you take to make their money? Mm. Then I told myself like, honestly, within less than a year, I can make their money back. Mm. So the only thing that happened to me financially was that I was just set back by about less than a year. Mm. Yeah, and when I really thought about it, like, wow, it suddenly gave me this like clarity, you know? Mm. And then I was thinking also like, what else can I do? What could I have done with this money, or would I have done with this money?
Then probably would have bought NFTs lah. Then still same.
No, but it made me appreciate, or actually disassociate myself with greed. Mm. I realized that I was constantly chasing these numbers, right? Chasing for an entire year. That I kind of neglected everything else. Yeah, everything seemed to have to have, like I have to pack a value to it, and then if there's no value to it, right, or it's not worth an investment of sorts, right? Then I don't care. So it reframed my mind a little bit.
What's an example of one thing that you felt like you gave up in pursuit of this?
Like, there are a lot of things that I put off. Like, for example, I've been wanting like a full sleeve tattoo for the longest time, right? Yeah, but I keep putting things like that off. Or like pursuing, like for example, like hiring like a PT or this kind of thing, right? Like, all these things that I'm just putting
trainer.
Off.
Interesting. So it became like almost a dollar lesson, but a lesson that seems a lot more valuable. Than
That's more than my entire net worth, Sarah. I didn't just like you say that.
No, your kidneys, 300 grand.
Okay. I'm a millionaire.
Yeah, the funny thing is that the moment I lost the money, it was actually during a shoot. During a TDK shoot, I was sitting right here and I was watching my money bleed out in the morning. But
then after that, John asked you, hey, why are you on your phone?
No, so can I say?
Yeah.
So I remember, to me, John will always be a very weird person that I just cannot figure out, right? He still is. And I remember I was playing mahjong with my parents and my friends that night. And then I saw the notification that he texted me. I think it was like 10, 11 o'clock already, right?
That's your bedtime, eh?
No. Weekend, no. So after he said, I mean, because it's truncated, right? It's a notification. Then he just said, need some advice. Then I thought this guy must be in fucking shambles already. Because we have this weird ass relationship where this brother comes to me for advice. And I know it's like a Friday or a weekend, so like you don't need fucking advice from me, right? So then we actually stopped the mahjong game. I went to the room to properly think and reply him. Then I saw this thing and we debated about whether he should take back his capital or continue to. Because I also understand, because I'm also, I also risk-taker.
Oh, as it happened.
In the middle of it. Just before the bum.
Two days before the plummet. Because I was thinking, then I did ask him, I said, is it a small amount? Is it a small amount to up your margin? So if it's small amount up margin, then I'll just pass to you, then we just gamble lah, right? You fucking give me back, you give me 5% interest, I'll also show, you know what I mean? Give me 1%, I'll also show, it's like 3 days to make this money only, ma. So then we talk about it, then after that, I don't know what, I think we arrived at take the loss, right?
I think so.
Yeah,
I think
so. Take the loss. Then the next day, I asked him how, then he said, he forgot.
Huh?
Or some shit. Oh, you say you greedy then you wanted to.
No,
wait.
I chose. No, so it ended quite open-endedly. Like he was trying to like help me to think out the process, right, and make a decision. But there were kind of like two options like at hand lah. Then in the end, I decided to gamble. I want to say like.
No, I think in my head it was we concluded at you take back the money. Like you take your okay.
Is it okay? No, but at the end of the day, right? Like. I think I look at money very differently now.
Yeah, he took it like a champ, man, to be honest. If it's me, right, I'll be freaking devastated.
Yeah.
Then I was like, you okay, no? He said, no. Then after that, he kena under my wellness scope, right? when I would check in on him.
How are you,
scope? How's everything? He said, personally, okay. Is it like financially, you'll be sian, no? But personally, like life and work, I feel good. Then I was like, wow, you can separate.
Damn.
Yeah. I lose 50 grand, I cannot feel good. Oh. No fucking way. Like midway during sex, I don't feel good.
No, so there's one last thing that I took away from this, right, which I really, really treasure, right, was that the moment that the whole crash was happening, I had to top up quite a lot of money on the spot, lah. And I couldn't access my cash because I have a lot of things invested everywhere else, right? Mm. So not enough liquid, cash, lah. I was like, I text one of my best friends, right? Then she just straight away give me her bank account, let me Like, pass me whatever amount of money I need, that kind of thing. Yeah. Then not enough. That's my mother also. Then my mother is also like, she and money, like, it's interesting, okay, their relationship. Yeah. But even then, right, it must have been very, very difficult for her, I feel. Yeah. But she just like, yeah, just like that. Then in that moment, I feel like, wow, shit.
So got people are, that... You are loved.
Yeah.
Why you never shout at me? I also offer you money, or you just never take.
Okay, la, yala. Hey, thank you. But no, but yeah, really, la. Like, just like that, you know. Mm. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's very good silver lining.
Yeah.
But you must remember, eh.
Of course, of course.
I want to say the next time, right, is a bull season, right? For whatever investment instrument, right, you need to relearn this lesson over and over again, man. You will feel the greed again, man. Then you need to...
No, so then the takeaway for the rest of us is to, if he ever say I need advice, say sell.
I've been buying Toto ever since.
It's a very safe investment instrument.
Maybe you'll strike bigger.
So I also like gambler like you, right? So if you can learn from some of my shit, right? It's a true thing, right? I reverse calculate how much money I need, or like, what's the amount that I want when I'm 50 years old in one financial instrument,
yeah,
right? Which is diversified one. So I use Syfe, nothing to do with our sponsor. I really use Syfe, right? Yeah, so I calculate the amount I need to put every month, then from my age all the way until there to hit, actually my number is 1,000. Yeah. I need to put $1,000 a month into Syfe to hit 1.something million at age 50.
Mm-hmm. Wait, yeah. So do you have that one safe investment?
Oh my god.
Yeah, so no, you should.
It's something for you to think about, so sir.
Everything else, right, I go for exponential return. Like 10% will not do kind of shit, you know, I go and play, but if shit hits the fan at 50, I know I'm going to take $1 million.
Wow, actually 1,000 is quite reasonable for $1 million at the end of.
Yes.
Need that
compound.
Yeah. Everything else, like, okay lah, but whatever, learn not. 2022 will be the year of safe investment. No, that doesn't.
That's a terrible year to save investments. Yeah. You buy stable coins.
To go crazy, then. Yeah.
Oh, another highlight of 2022 was we started the daily catch-up.
Oh yeah. Hey.
Oh yeah, shit, I should say that's mine. That's my highlight.
But so afterthoughts, yeah.
Yeah,
no. I got no.
You have no highlight?
No highlight.
Your gambling experiences, your cruises?
Yeah, I learned that I was compulsive gambler.
You learned the helpline.
Yeah, okay. I mean, good stuff have. But I think I was thinking about what's the worst thing that happened to me. And then, to have, very lucky. But anyway,
us la.
We started new brands like the Daily Catch Up and Chain Debrief.
Chain Debrief.
Also, that the office took another floor within the building.
Which to us is
very exciting. Yeah, so like, that's a huge milestone.
But then, what were some lessons that you learned then, if you don't have like high or low lights per se?
I relearned this lesson that I might have shared in our town hall in our previous company, right? Like two things. The first one is that sometimes in order to help your colleagues, right, the best thing you can do is to not help them. It might sound weird, but that's a very good recipe for growth.
For their growth.
For their growth, correct.
Oh, so that's why you never reply me, huh?
Yeah, I mean, because I always over
support. But then it became your highlight.
See? There? I was still recovering from a trauma of 20, of a social trauma, right?
2019.
Yeah, it made me very insecure of myself as a person, as a friend. And then I closed up as a result. And then thankfully not thankfully, but due to COVID, right? There's no reason to
go out and have
go
friends.
Out and mingle. Yeah, so you stay at home anyway. So you never really did test how that scarred feeling was. But then I had a realization in like last year, which was that you gotta keep your heart open, because even though there'll be people that would hurt it, right? It's better that than to live a life where you feel like there's no meaningful connection.
Jeez.
That is a very real thing for me. Eh.
Mm. Or yeah. You can do bloodletting to cure your heartbreak.
Yeah, I can do bloodletting. No, it was not a heartbreak. It was more of a, I doubt myself, you know? So it's about rebuilding that confidence again. Mm. Yeah, in order to rebuild that confidence, you have to open up again.
Do you think there were people who helped you with that? Or was that like internal? Like you had to realize it yourself.
No, I never told anybody. Yeah.
Hey, thanks for sharing.
Because you're just making fun of me every time I say it.
No lah, it's very hard to.
Yeah, actually this year I also did the whole opening up thing.
Yeah, like, I can tell slowly. The, you open up 2% and it took you 1.
This is the first year that I started like dating. Like seriously after like,
you mean last year lah, yeah.
Oh yeah, last year.
Eating ass again. Ooh, drink that shit. Stop.
Live demonstration.
Yeah, drink up the air.
You look happier.
You do. Yeah. I like her already.
Like that is no happier. Her.
No, like.
Oh. What are the highlights of your year?
So at the start of 2021, right, my mom came to me and right, she said, you are going to get a huge project this year. And then at that point, like, huge to me meant like maybe like 10K. Because like the previous year, the biggest that I did was like 5 lah. So then after that, closer towards the end of the, like the third quarter around there, then I really got a huge project. Eh. Oh. Like it's, sick. I think like 2 months of work is my entire year's pay.
Wow.
So that was quite crazy for me. Nice, and it was like a good, it was a great opportunity because the thing that we were doing was quite a meaningful thing also.
Right.
Like the video campaign was for. Yeah, so I think like something that I had maybe been a bit struggling with like in the past year was like, in a sense,
how to manage all that money you have, lah.
How to find a bit of meaning in my work, I guess.
Yeah.
Maybe because a bit of my religion, right? And then some of, like at work, we talk a lot about. I mean, we make a lot of like sex jokes, for example.
Right.
And then certain content that we do might not fall very in line with my church, lah. And that's something that people ask me. Like at John Paul and I have had this conversation before as well. Yeah. So then I think like at the end of the day, yeah, like, I think it helped kind of help me realize that like I'm building up to something, lah. That I'm building up, I can do content that is more closer to my heart, right? Yeah. I can do content that is
the godly ketchup.
No, but does it make you uncomfortable though?
No, because like whatever we, I feel like I'm detached from it. Like whatever we do, I don't think I perpetuate that in my own life.
Yeah.
Like outside of here, I don't make like sex jokes, like, that kind of
thing. Oh no, I still do lah.
Okay, it's so different.
But, I mean, to me, like it's just a joke.
Yeah. In a bit like finding meaning, that kind. And I also read something at the start of 2021 that was quite interesting. That it was by Mark Manson.
Oh, so I thought you were going to read your horoscope.
I start counting. So then he talked about how happiness is the wrong question. Because there were some parts of 2020 where I felt like I was sad, but for no good reason. And then I felt upset that I couldn't identify why I was sad. And then that made me even sadder.
Right.
And then I didn't want to like talk to anybody. But I don't think I was depressed.
Right.
Yeah. Like, I think I just felt like I was just trying to figure things out, lah. Yeah, lah. Which I felt like this year did give me some clarity on that, lah. Yeah, so I think that's my highlight of the year.
It's a good year?
It's a so-so. Like, I don't think there's anything that sticks out to me.
Right.
Like to you, lah. Like, good things happen throughout the year. But I don't think I have a big thing. Like, because even this monetary thing, right, like, to me, it's like, at the end of it, my end goal is, like, not money per se. Right?
It's just money, lah.
Yeah. Like the other day, I asked the office quite quite an interesting question, I feel.
You shouldn't ask me, you should ask her.
We were having lunch. So then I asked the colleagues that we were with, like, if you had 10K right now, right, but you cannot invest, right, what would you buy? Then I was thinking, like, because I'm investing so that I can get something, what? So then if I had the money right now, what would I get? Then I couldn't think of anything, eh. Then I'm like, huh? Then do I really need this money to be happy? So
damn, I also cannot think of anything.
That was the same mentality or like the same thought process that I went through also. But then I also think about it like, there are so many other things that you need to factor in when you are trying to accumulate wealth for the long
example?
Term. Like it's a long-term goal lah. What if one day you really like, you cannot find a job or whatever, can you tide through that period? Or if something happens and you fork out that kind of money, like, there's definitely like, it is important one, right? It's just that you need to find a balance between being able to also buy the things or afford the things that you want to be able to live. Yeah.
Which is why I think that like at the end of it, like money buys peace of mind, lor.
Yeah.
And so to tie back to resolutions, right? Like for this year, I feel like I want to have like a healthier relationship with money. Like not so much see as like something I'm chasing,
right?
But something that helps me like along the way to like achieve certain personal goals and all that I have, lor. But this year, are you planning on setting resolutions? Since I tell you about the benefits, right, of setting resolutions, you tell me one.
No, actually, I wanted to ask, like, should you set, like, a very...
grand?
Like, do you think you all can manage your set, like, say, like, 5 goals for the year? You know what I mean? Or are you all, like, a one goal at a time kind of person? Because even if I were to establish my goals, right, they would be, like, maybe for the first quarter of the year, this is my goal. Then the second quarter, this is what I want to do.
But quarter feels like too short of a time to achieve something.
Or maybe half year, lor. Or maybe there's like one that takes a full year and then the rest are like shorter.
You know, I don't like odd numbers.
Okay, good for you.
So, so I cannot set like 2 goals. Like that irritates me.
But that's an even number.
Even so, I like odd numbers. I don't like even numbers.
You like
so like 2, 4, 6, right? It's like E.
Oh,
I really dislike these numbers.
What happened?
Like, so do you all have like one big
goal? Yeah, so I was saying, so I usually set either one resolution or three.
Right.
Because I don't like to.
So I have two, as usual. The first is to learn Chinese again.
You call my mom. My mom's a Chinese tutor.
Hey, yeah. Okay, I don't mind. Hey, no, but your mom
sounds very scary.
Yeah, your mom sounds very scary.
It depends on your level.
And
yeah,
I,
if you're not,
faster.
If
no,
you're,
I don't thrive in that kind of environment. I panic.
No, but if you're not taking any tests, then there's no need to panic.
我不要。 Then
that's
the whole class.
Then she'll correct your pronunciation for 我不要.
At the end of the day, I'll see what you learn. Auntie, 不要打我.
My second resolution is kind of related to what my highlight was, which is that because I said yes so much, right, I felt like I really spread myself too thin. And it's also the most tired I've ever been in my entire life. So next year, no, so this
it's
year.
The year of no.
It's the year to say no a little bit more.
You can learn from him, he's very good at saying no.
Yeah, okay. At the end of the day, you go back and forth until you find that sweet spot, right?
Equilibrium.
Yeah. You eh? For 2022.
He said he don't set goals.
Don't set goals.
No, so what's the company's goal?
Later got tongue.
Don't have goals.
I feel like I'm at the stage now, right? I just...
Or is there an area of your life?
I just want to understand what's enough for me.
Alright.
Yeah. Like him, I feel like I picked out early. But my pick not even like his pick. Like I was never like, wow, class chairman, don't have. I just feel... It was lower than that, but yet I still feel like I picked out too early. Yeah. Then it was always a constant pursuit and chase of the next thing and the next thing and the next thing. And whenever I look back and I take stock, right, I always know that I am luckier than most. Like the opportunity, the things I have, right, I would say 80% is because I happen to be at the right place, right time, not because I'm the best man for the job.
But do you think that maybe on a subconscious level you are putting yourself there?
Like you're creating your own luck. Like what maybe, Dan likes
yeah,
to
yeah,
say.
Sure, maybe. Yeah. Yeah.
Like cause 100% of the time nobody's in the exact same place that you are at, right?
Yeah, no lah. But I also know it's not ability in that sense.
Yep, yep.
You know, it's the simple things like showing up. Yeah, but it's not, you know, that's not resolution level, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Why
so,
why is it not resolution level?
Yeah, show up.
I always show up.
Oy.
Hey, why? I always show up. Okay. Yeah, no, but honestly, so I'm trying to find out. Like Pat and I always have this conversation that we look at the people around us, right? Where they have much less, but they seem so much more carefree and so much happier. And their struggles seem so much smaller. But yet you know it's that struggle is their world.
Cliche.
You know what I'm saying?
Sorry. Yeah. No. I agree. No lah. It's really real.
Why you always put him down?
No, so I realized, right, that my resolutions are not specific nor measurable.
Okay, you change one.
JP! Yeah.
Safer investing.
You should build back that pot lah.
It's double it. That's yeah.
Beautiful.
But then you're still chasing money. No, and not that I want to project my goals on you.
So I do have a financial goal, but it's not going to be conflated with everything else. Love like that. I know how to separate it lah. Yeah, that was the lesson that I learned ma. And also get a sexy body.
That's what you told me this year.
That's been my resolution for the last 20 years.
No, but like, cause I've always felt like my body image, right?
Yeah.
Has affected like maybe like confidence, self-esteem in other aspects of my life also.
Yeah.
So I think that this is something that I just need to quickly address that I can do more things with the rest of my life. Eh?
I agree. Yeah.
So I want to like just like
good shit.
Yeah.
It's a journey though, I wanna say.
It is
life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not you can't sprint a nice body. You will lose it all as quickly as you got it.
You have to marathon a nice body.
You're dropping real nuggets here, yeah.
You're being very reflective. Stop f***ing on shitting.
You fart?
No, I never.
Oh,
trying to show like I got PTSD from you.
starting the year right, guys. So we talked quite a bit about setting resolutions and then after reviewing our year, I find that like at the crux of it, right, it's about setting value-driven resolutions. So what you value and then how can you get there like with your smart goals. So tying it back to our sponsor.
The dumbass goals.
Which is Saif, who is here to help you achieve your financial goals.
Yay, Saif. Thank you, Saif.
Yes, yeah, you need help a safer investing option.
A cipher.
No, Saif also got aggressive one. Yeah. So I use the aggressive one as my safe one.
Look at you, gambler.
Yeah, so nothing I learned about
there's
myself.
More information down below about Saif and you can go and read up about it.
Yeah, always have a secondary plan, especially when it comes to money, right? We always want to invest to get more money, but don't make one bad investment decision derail everything you've accumulated in the last few years.
Mm. And there are always various options. Even with Sai, for example, they have more aggressive portfolios from a list of already curated stocks.
They got cash
stocks.
Portfolios also.
So go read up about it and comment your resolutions down below.
Yes, I'm honestly curious, like what are people's resolutions?
Yeah.
Like besides the fitness goals for the first 3 months, like, you know.
Yeah, let us know actually. Yeah.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year! Bye bye!
Like, share, subscribe. Bye bye.